What's going on, guys? It's Mr. DTA416 here with a cool little video for you guys to enjoy. I want to show you guys what I've been using in Titanfall so far after the first day of the game launching. It's March 11th, and I want to show you guys what I've been using, so maybe when you unlock it, or even if you have it, maybe you want to throw it on your class or on your Titan and use it. So first of all, I want to go into my pilot and show you guys what my five classes are. After I got my SMG, I think at a low level, it was like 15 or something like that. I leveled it up a lot, and I wanted to get a HCOG scope for it, which is actually really good. I found out that the iron sight's good, but I like the HCOG a little more because it's kind of more accurate. I don't really like the suppressor on the submachine gun. It's alright if you don't want to be seen on the radar, but I don't really like too much stuff in that category for the SMG. Scatter fire's alright, just kind of increases the fire rate, that's about it. When I get extended mag, I'll probably be throwing that on there, because it just gives you more ammo, so I'll probably be throwing that on there when I kill a couple more Spectre there. So that's my first class. On that class, I have the anti-titan weapon, the charge rifle, and the reason I have that is because I just unlocked it. But my favorite, I think, out of all these, I don't know, the Sidewinder is pretty good, and I usually use that on a lot of my classes, especially at a low level, because you have it unlocked. But the charge rifle is pretty cool. It's one of those guns that kills pilots as quick as it does Titans, so charge rifle is really good to use, I think, if when you unlock it at about 30-something, I think you unlock it. 20, up higher 20s, low 30s, you unlock it. So going on here, the B3 Wingman, I'm actually going to put it on because it's like a two-hit kill to the chest if you shoot the pilot. And it's really, really strong, and I think it's one of the better sidearms you can have. The RE45 auto pistol is pretty good. Hammond's all right. It's more accurate if you just run up and run and gun with it. I mean, it's more, you know, it does more damage if you just go around spraying people with it. But overall, I think the B3 Wingman's pretty good. And you get it, I think you get it high 20s, I'm pretty sure. So it's not that hard to get if you play the game enough. And I'm sure a lot of you do who are watching this because the game is really popular. I use the active radar pulse on my SMG. I don't know why. I just kind of wanted to have it on one of my classes. And this is the only class I have the active radar pulse on. Because what it does is it lets you see through walls, and you can see enemies and stuff through walls and stuff, which is pretty cool. But Stim is my favorite, and it would make sense. Oh shit. Okay, sorry. That was an advertisement. It would make sense that Stim would be on an SMG class, but I just keep the active radar pulse on there, which, like I said before, lets you see through walls. But Stim, what it does is it lets you run faster, so you can run around the map a lot faster and stuff, and I use it on just about all my classes. Ordnance, I like the shock grenades or the arc grenades, whatever. Satchel charges are alright. The C4 satchel charge has a huge radius in this game, so you can throw it at a Titan and just blow them up with like two or three of them. So satchel charges are good. I still like the arc grenade because it like stuns Titans, and I like that, and then I can run up and jump on them, rodeo them. Arc mine's pretty good too. Arc mine, you get at a high level, like 30s. There's 50 levels, by the way. Arc mine is like 30 something, and arc mine, I don't know. I just use it some. I use it on my other one of my other classes, and I just run around, and just throw it, and just, you know, hope that it blows someone up. It's like a claymore. The tier kits, I don't really care about the tier kits too much. I have the explosive pack on here, which increases your ordnance ammo capacity, which is the grenade. So instead of holding I think two or three of them, I hold four. So I like that one myself, but the power cell is pretty good. I haven't unlocked any other ones yet because I'm not the top level just yet, but when I get top level, I'll probably be making one more of these videos to tell you guys my favorite throughout the prestige. And if you guys want to know about the prestige system in this game, I'm gonna make one more video probably tomorrow on the prestige system, so you guys can come back tomorrow probably around 3 or 4, and I'll have a prestige video for you guys because the prestige system's a little weird in this game. But yeah, getting back to the class here. I like the Warfall transmitter, or Warpfall transmitter. There we go. Increases, accelerates your Titan's sustainability, short range jump technology, blah blah blah. It's pretty good. I like it. The minion detector is pretty good too. Maybe I'll throw that down there because this is not really helpful that much. But the minion detector detects all the little grunts and stuff on the map for your Titan. So, the tier two is the Titan enhancing perk kind of thing. And then the dome shield, which is all right. And then you can change your gender. So that's my first class. The second class is a little bit similar. I have the carbine with HCOG, and I'm not going to go into it because I just showed you guys pretty much what it is. I have the carbine with HCOG, the mag launcher. I like the, like I said before, I like the mag launcher because well, I said I like the Sidewinder. The mag launcher is kind of the same thing, only it's not as fast. It shoots like giant grenades. And what I do is sometimes when I'm taking flags and domination, I'll use the mag launcher to make sure that there's no one in the room, and I'll just shoot a couple grenades in there and clear it out with the mag launcher. So it helps when you're not going against Titans too. So even though it's an anti-Titan weapon, I do like to use it when I'm not going against Titans. Sidearm B3 again, the shotgun pistol I call it, two hits to the chest of dead. I'm rocking Stim again, like I said before. It increases your running ability so you can run faster, and I think that's extremely helpful in this game because some of these maps are actually really big, and you need, especially for domination, capture the flag, you would need Stim to help you get around the map a little faster. Ordnance, I got the Arc Mine on this class. Like I said before, Arc Mine, I just kind of threw it on here because I just unlocked it. I might take it off in the future. Like I said, I like the Arc Grenade, which is the shock grenades where you can stun the big Titan. Power Cell, which is your pilot's tactical ability, recharges faster. So my tactical, which is the Stim, recharges a little faster because after you use it, it has to recharge. So I have that because I like the Stim, and like I said, it helps. Minion detector on this class. So that's my second class. My third one, the G2A4, and this is really what you guys want to listen to, is the G2A4. I thought was going to be a shitty gun, and I used it two or three games without any attachments, obviously, and I was like, it's all right. It's a semi-automatic gun because it's a rifle, and after I used it for a little bit, I went like 10 and like 2 with it, and then I kept going up and up. I was like 15 and like 3, and then I did like 20 and like 5, and I think it's one of the better guns in this game. You get it at like 20 something, or no, actually, you get it at 17. I'm sorry, you get it at 17 because I remember I wanted to get it because I've seen people using it on YouTube, and it's pretty good actually. I really would suggest using it when you unlock it. Put HCOG on it. Let me show you what you can get for HCOG, AOG, holographic. Holographic's pretty good. I was using it for a while actually, and I think they don't tell you on the side there. It doesn't say it increases anything, but I actually think it increases accuracy because when you're scoping down people, it's got that little dot in the middle that lets you see enemies and stuff and hit them at farther distances. So it's pretty good. HCOG, I'm just using it because I just unlocked it for the gun. And suppressor, I don't really like suppressor on it. It kind of makes it weaker, and it says right there the damage does decrease. And I will definitely use extended mag when I get it for it, but right now I'm just using the match trigger, which when you're trying to trigger finger, like shoot the gun, right? It increases your speed. So if you're shooting the thing faster, it'll kind of like kick in and like shoot the gun faster. So I do like the match trigger a little bit, and that's for like hand combat sort of thing, like when you're right next to someone, not like 100 yards away or whatever. So pretty good. Anti-tank weapon, charge rifle. This is one of the classes I use a lot, and since I just unlocked the charge rifle, I threw it on there just so I could try it out once in a while when I was running with this gun. So I do like this gun. I want to just tell you guys before I have this gun on another class. I don't want to get to that, but the gun I'm going to be using when I unlock it the most probably is this one because it's an automatic gun and it's pretty sick, and the LMG as well. So I will definitely be doing some gameplays of those two. And this sniper's pretty cool, but these two guns right here are going to be crazy. I only have one more level to get this one, and then another 5 levels to get that one. So 5 or 6. I'm pretty sure it's 6. So anyways, that's my third class. My fourth class here, the Hemlock BFR, 3-round burst gun, pretty good. I haven't gotten any attachments for it. I just unlocked it a couple levels ago. I'm rocking Cloak on there because I haven't really gotten the chance to edit my class too much. Cloak, I'll probably change it to Stim eventually. Arc Grenade, Enhanced Parkour Kit, which means you can run on walls a lot faster and a lot longer and stuff. It's pretty helpful, especially on maps with a lot of buildings. The Minion Detector, again, the Sidewinder, as usual, I like the Sidewinder. I might put the Charge Rifle, Rifle on there, because I have been using this gun a little more, because I'm trying to get some attachments for it and get some challenges so I can level up a little faster. But overall, pretty good. The B3, again, on there, because B3 is one of the best pistols, I think, in this game. I think it is the best pistol in this game. And on my last class, I have the Sniper, which I will be changing when I level up one more time to get this gun. I want to show you guys real quick the Titan loadouts I have, because that's really what I wanted to share with you guys when I made this video. So my first Titan loadout, I don't have all five yet. I have to wait two more levels. I think I'm 33, right? Am I 33? Yeah, I am. My first one, I only use two, so I'm only going to show you guys two. And as I get more and more stuff unlocked, because I actually don't have a lot unlocked for my Titans, because there's most of the stuff you unlock at higher levels. But my first one here is the Triple Threat, and I just unlocked this two levels ago, I think. And what it is it's a grenade launcher, but it shoots like three grenades, either horizontal or vertical. And if you can shoot, it shoots, I think, three sets of three, so it's nine. So you could shoot nine, like, exploding little balls at Titans, and you can shoot them in buildings where flags are. I honestly think this is probably one of the best primary guns you can have for the Titan. I want to go through the guns real fast. I don't really like the cannon too much. It's alright if you want to go around trying to blow people up. Quad rocket, I think, is probably, in my opinion, it's stupid. The chain gun is one of my favorites. The plasma railgun and the arc cannon are both really stupid. This one has a lot of good stats on the bottom right there, but take it from me, it's really not that good of a gun. The arc cannon's the same thing. It's kind of just, it's just a beam of lightning, which is really stupid, I think, honestly. But the triple threat, probably my favorite gun, primary gun, ahead of the chain gun. I like the chain gun because it kills the Titan pretty fast, but the triple threat, I think, is a little faster to kill. And I want to tell you why, because if you have the right setup on your Titan, you're going to dominate. Okay? When I unlock the Ogre, I'm going to throw the Ogre on. Alright? I am going to... give me a second. Yeah, okay. So when I get the Ogre... Sorry, I just lost my train of thought. Electric smoke, all right? So when you walk up to the other Titan, you can drop the electric smoke, right? What it does is it stuns them. And then that's when I just start hammering them with the little balls that this triple threat gun shoots. In the ordnance, I like the warheads, and I like the multi-targeted missile system, which I just unlocked, which is pretty good. The slave warheads are really good. They do a lot of damage, and a multi-targeted missile system. So when I get going, I just drop that smoke, shoot them with the gun, and just hammer them with the missiles. So it's pretty good. This is a great class, and I really would suggest using it. As for the tier kits down here, I haven't unlocked everything for them yet. When I unlock everything, I'll do, like I said, I'm going to do another video when I'm 50. But I use the fast autoloader so I can get my missiles back. My multi-target missile system back pretty quick. And I use the thing where I lose my health slower when I'm doomed, which is like when you lose all your health and then you have like a certain amount of time to leave your Titan before you blow up. I like that because then it gives me more time to just keep hammering the other Titans. So I do pretty good with this class. I would really honestly suggest using it when you play it and when you unlock all this stuff. I'm only 30, so you should be, you know, like I said, you should be able to get this stuff by the time you're 30 or whatever, or 33 I am, but I haven't locked too much stuff in the past three levels. And the other one I use, like I said, is the chain gun. They're the only two guns I really like for the Titans. I use the accelerator for the chain gun because what it does is if you have extended mag in it, which I don't have, you can't put extended mag in the accelerator at the same time. I think you could do that in the beta. I don't really remember, to be honest. But accelerator is pretty good. what it does is it gets faster and faster, like an like acceleration is what it, you know, referring to, obviously. And you can just hammer a zombie. You can hammer a Titan. Man, it's crazy. So, accelerator, definitely an attachment I would try and get if you want to use the chain gun. Extended mag's pretty good. Particle wall, I don't know. It's alright. I like the smoke myself, but particle wall is pretty good. It's a shield that you can shoot through, but they can't shoot you through. So, I definitely would try it out if you guys are interested. Ordnance, I have the multi-target missile system on there again because I wanted to try it out. So I just unlocked it. And I have the core extender down here, and I didn't know what it did, so I threw it on there. But what it does is the core extender allows any Titan core ability to remain active for an extended period of time. So I guess the core, which is like the damage core, is longer. So when you get your damage core, you can hold it longer. And I think I may actually throw that on this one. So we'll try it out on this class too. So those are my two Titan classes. I hope you guys enjoy this video. And I hope it recorded because my thing here. Okay, yeah, I recorded it. All right, so thank you guys for watching. I am Mr. DTA416. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button. And don't forget to subscribe for more awesome Titanfall videos, tips, tricks, and more. I'll be bringing you guys a lot more videos in the coming week. And I'll catch you guys later.